I'm Robin Morrison. I'm a dental practice management and marketing consultant. And today I'm here with my friend Linda Miles. And Linda, you're going to be sharing your best practices to retain patients during a practice transition with us today.
Wow.
Big job.
It's a big job, Robin. But, you know, normal attrition after one doctor retires or leaves a practice and hands it to the newer doctor, the normal attrition rate is about 20-25%. And that can be smaller, but in many cases, sadly, we've both seen it much higher. And one of the things that I feel, we both feel so deeply about is relationship. Dentistry is not about how beautiful the crown and the margins, it's how you make that patient feel. Mm-hmm. So studying the senior dentist and knowing how he or she, what their philosophy of patient care, and more importantly, what their philosophy of team care, because the worst thing a young doctor can do when they take over is go in like a bulldozer and want to change it so rapidly that they make it theirs. I love the fact that it will be theirs and probably is already theirs, or I don't know how long the buy-in was, but the main thing is to realize that dentistry is a relationship practice, so they have to absolutely follow what's in place but gradually make the changes that they wish to make in that. And I think the first step in of any practice is for the dentist to write their mission, their goals, their, unless the team understands what this doctor wants, they really truly cannot support that. And I think that's why systems break down. The doctor has not written their mission, their philosophy, their goals, and how can the team get on board with something they don't understand? So it's great to be different, but not so much all at once the first few months.
Right, and should there be a certain degree of alignment as far as philosophy?
I feel there should be. If you are a total fee-for-service, high quality, practice of excellence, and you bring in someone who has come from another practice environment that's more like an emergency clinic, low fees, little time with the patient, I don't think it's going to go over as well. Mm-hmm. And I've seen a lot of young dentists come in with very high goals of having a total fee-for-service, high-quality, Nordstrom-type practice, but they're buying a PPO practice. And that type of a change, mm-hmm. I always say, take a look at what percentage of your patients are on those plans. Gradually get to where you're going in a year or two, but you can pull the professional rug out from under yourself and lose a ton of patients mm-hmm. if you go in and say, I'm the new sheriff in town and we're gonna do it this way.
Right.
The team also is very important in this patient retention, because if the team members are not praising and appreciating the doctor, and so many times I find that if the senior doctor sticks around a long time, whether it be 6 months or a year, I find that the team members are very hesitant to endorse the new doctor
right.
because it looks like I'm being disloyal to the man or woman who signed my paycheck for years.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't really support the young doctor.
Right, right. Do you see an ideal or best way to announce this new associate to the practice, to the patients?
I think it's great to have two open houses, one for your patient base, and ask them to bring a neighbor or a friend who may not have a personal dentist to meet them.
Mm-hmm.
And this is usually after hours or on a Sunday afternoon from 2 to 4. And I also believe we should have a professional open house, and that might be from 5:30 to 7, and invite all of the professional colleagues of the senior dentist to introduce the young dentist.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's real key
mm-hmm.
in acceptance.
Yeah, I love that. I think that's so important too.
I do too.
Thank you for sharing your tips today. These are really important tips to apply to your practice when going through this type of transition.